one ear this, depending.
Because there's a little that. Oh, we're live! Oh, hey, we're live! I love the surprises of a live show. Hi, everybody, and welcome to the weekly Rocksmith 2014 All New Edition chat. What on earth was that?
Sorry, everybody.
Godzilla is outside, I guess. So, hey, welcome. And this week you're in for a treat, hopefully. We're going to be doing something a little bit different. I'm happy to say that this week's Audio Slave DLC is live pretty much everywhere on PS3, PC, and Xbox 360. And you can get it now, and we're going to show it to you in a minute. But we're not actually going to be playing it this week. We're doing something special. And full disclosure, licensing music is a tricky thing. And this week, we simply don't have the rights to do something as big as streaming. We can show you a little bit in the preview video, but we actually don't have permission to do it. But that's cool. We still obviously say, hey, go out, get the DLC. There's plenty to learn from it. But we won't be playing it this week, and so this was the perfect opportunity to bring a familiar face on the show, Taylor Benson. Hi, Taylor.
Hey, Dan.
How are you?
Very good. How
thanks.
Are you?
Thanks. I'm feeling fine, and thanks for joining me on the couch.
Sure, sure. It's my pleasure. This couch is kind of comfy.
No, it's not. It's from IKEA.
not a sponsor.
There goes that sponsorship. We love Ernie Ball, and we have some prizes for Ernie Ball, but IKEA, you know, who can tell? You're going to be one of our participants this week in the first Guitarcade Showdown.
That's true. When I watched the stream last week, I felt compelled to throw my hat into the ring.
Because you think you can win.
Watch it.
Yeah, we have all of the other contestants are right here off camera, and we're going to be doing this through some time-honored methods, but I'll get into that in a minute. First, let's take a look at that Audio Slave DLC I was talking about. Here's a little peek of what you can get on the store this week.
Long
Yes, Audio Slave, of course, you may know that as Rage Against the Machine minus Zach DeLaRocca plus Chris Cornell. So a bit of a super group there, and five really good songs. We were just saying during that video, gee, it's kind of a drag that we can't play them this week, but it is what it is, and I'm sure Toy Machine will send you towards people doing playthrough videos so that you can see the full charts, as he always does. So, a real quick housekeeping thing, because this is the first DLC that's been available on the PlayStation Store in 3 or 4 weeks. There has been this huge technical issue or something on the Sony PlayStation Store in Europe only, which then, of course, feeds other areas like the UK and Australia, and so it gets very sticky. But Creed, Shinedown, and Foreigner have not been available, even though if you go to Sony's blog, it says totally available now. So we've been trying to figure out what's going on with them, and we asked, is it something that we did? They said, no, it's cool, it's on our side, we'll figure it out. Well, this morning, about 45 minutes before we started broadcasting, we got news. And this is, fingers crossed, we believe that this content will be updated tomorrow, October 10th, in the Sony store in Europe. So, again, cautiously optimistic. We're not sure what time it would go up. So if you check and it's not there, check again later in the day. We'll be tracking this on our forums. That's rocksmith.ub.com. Go in there. There's a dedicated thing under the DLC discussions where I'm keeping everybody updated on whatever I know. But hopefully this whole thing, it's a mess, I know, but hopefully it's all over as of tomorrow. So go check it out. Report back if you're in one of those affected areas. We appreciate it. So with that good news, let's make some trouble. So here's what we're going to do, and most of the people in the room don't really understand this yet either. I have a Ubisoft mug because I care Darren Wynn. So in this mug is our 10 names. I have 10 people on staff. Some of them are full-time note trackers. Some of them are from the audio team. Some of them may be locked outside of our studio. I'm not really sure. But the idea is that this is going to be, because we had 10 people, I couldn't do a nice like 8-person tournament brackety thing. So we're going to do this much more like a wrestling event. So we're going to have 5 one-on-one matches on 5 different Guitarcade games. I'm going to pick the first name. The person who's on this is going to pick the person they'll be playing, and then that person will pick, and so on and so forth. First up is Matt. Is Matt here yet?
Oh,
no. Is Matt coming today? Matt said he was in.
Yeah, he said he's on it.
He's on his way?
Yeah.
All right, then Matt gets a bye. Oh, he's lucky.
Especially if that other name is me.
Sam is here. Oh, yeah. I have Sam, so Sam is first. Come on up, Sam. Sam Schwartz, come on around. You can, well, yeah, actually, go around the back. And Taylor, if you could pop out. You'll be back here soon enough. Oh. And I expect you, if you're betting at home, and we do not recommend betting at home, but if you're betting at home, Taylor is the odds-on favorite because I think he spent more time as the associate producer screwing around with Guitarcade than anybody else, right?
I did screw around a lot during the development of Rocksmith 2014, so watch out.
All right, those are the hands of Sam. We'll bring Sam in here. And Sam, if you would reach into the Ubisoft mug once you get settled, just so the person knows who's on deck next. And you don't even know what game you're going to be playing yet. This is exciting.
I have no idea.
Okay, get one. Nick Bernardi. Is Nick Bernardi outside yet? Because he said he might be a little bit late. Is somebody coming? Oh, boy. This is all going to work itself out. Remember how I told everybody to be here 15 minutes early?
Yeah,
try again. And hopefully it won't be Matt, because I did put Matt back in there.
Pody.
Brian Pody on the Wheels of Steel. All right, you guys are up. You'll be up next. I'll take over for you, Brian. And I get to pick the game.
Ooh.
In a different Ubisoft mug,
so that we can tell them apart. Really. Where's the close-up cam when we need it on these beautiful Ubisoft mugs? You guys will be playing String Skip Saloon. So, here, we're all going to do it on the blue Les Paul, because even though it's not set up the way that some princesses like it, we're all going to play with one...
This princess.
Yeah, that's right. we're going to use all the same guitar, so it's fair. Oh, no, you don't need to re-log in. I had created a whole new profile just for this event. See how it says Guitarcade? You don't need to do multiplayer. Just go straight to single-player Guitarcade. We're good.
Guitarcade.
Oh, you crazy. All right.
How do you feel about string scripts?
Feeling the pressure, man.
Are you?
I'm really feeling it.
For those of you who have not seen these games, this is what you can play when you're not playing the songs of artists that you love. String Skip Saloon is a game that's designed... Yeah, I love the music. String Skip Saloon is designed to help you sort of automatically build a muscle memory to switch between the six individual strings. If you play this on bass, you can play these games on bass as well, and you'll just get, obviously, four strings. But I would say it's inspired by the classic arcade game Tapper while not actually being copyright infringement. I wish you good luck. Everybody's going to be starting at level one. As you play the Guitarcade games, you'll see there it says level one. The more you play, the higher your multiplier goes. So if you're in a high score fight with your friends or you're looking to lead on the leaderboards, the more you play a game, the higher your bonus will go. But for the purposes of today, everybody's going to be starting at level one, and everybody gets one go. That's it. So, Sam, I wish you the absolute best of luck. I will lean forward so that you can put that headstock wherever you want it, but I'm staying on the couch because I never get to be on the couch. I'll be checking your... oops, what? That's why I had it unplugged. I had everything set up, Pody. You know, it's so hard to find good note tracking help these days. There we go. Oh, that's true. You're and I even calibrated this for you before we came in, so everything should be up. You have no excuses, is what I'm telling you. But that's okay, because you don't have to be great, you just have to do better than Pody is about to do. So, yeah, there's the instructions. If you want them, shoot bandits by plucking the matching string, shoot the front runner for extra points, and then you'll get a couple of challenges that won't really matter. So there you go. Good luck, Sam. This is why we can't have nice things, says Zap. If you hit the back wall, it breaks your combo. You'll see combo break. And of course, we're starting out slow, but it's gonna get fast for Sam fairly quickly. Again, if one of those, oh, easy there, buddy. Nice shoot, Tex. The more portly cowboys that come in through the door need multiple hits to take them down. So you'll see that you have to just pluck the string like three times to get some points to go. And yes, if you hit the back wall, you break your combo, and you go down and score a little bit. Things are starting to speed up. Matt and Nick are here. Hi! You guys were already picked, so you went back. You went back in the mystical Ubisoft mug, and you're not out of this yet. Feels weird to see an E on top. I guess that's somebody that plays with the Druid like I do. Yes, E is on top either way. Oh, the green guy got past you, so 316, 148. That's not bad. And look, everybody's dancing. You did wind up getting a bunch of the Guitarcade challenges, but that's not enough to level up, so Brian will come in. Well done, Sam. You've set the standard. We have a benchmark, yeah. Do you need me to, I'm gonna just cut in front, I guess, because it's the easiest way to do it. All right, Mr. Pody, are you ready?
Sure.
Sure?
Let's have a go.
All right. All you have to do is beat 316,000, and you win. You win nothing, really, but you, I mean, I'll give you some Rocksmith stickers and picks, just like our award winners get. If you are here for the free things, we will be doing free things a little bit later. We've got some DLC codes for Steam for Audio Slave. And we've got... Oh, this may be over faster than you know! Oh! we've got some prizes from Ernie Ball as well. Remember, every time you hit the back wall with a shot that doesn't hit one of the oncoming attackers, you're going to reset your combo. Nobody's going to level up. Five different games will be shown today. String Skip Saloon is one. How many games are there total? 9 or 10? I'm not sure. There's 9 or 10 in the whole game. Guitar game games, if you were to play this at home, not competitively with your friends. 11. Oh, no, I was thinking these individual. Yes, Score Attack is also... Oh, you have beaten the score. You can drop the mic and walk away just in time, too. Sam, I'm sorry. Mr. Pody, well done. Yay! See, I was kind of hoping for some great, like, trash talking, you know, some old school wrestling, like,
Sam, you've been talking smack all week, but this weekend, we're gonna get this.
Yeah, Sam's so nice. That's the problem, is everybody here is such a sweet person. How can we possibly do this? All right, I know you guys are probably frothing at the mouth for free stuff, so before we pick the next person, or I would say while we pick the next person, Misty, what do you say we give away 5 codes for Audioslave DLC? I've sent Misty some codes for the 5 packs from Audioslave this week for Steam. So if you are a Steam gamer, you're going to want to follow Misty's instructions only when she tells you to follow her instructions. And you might win one of those 5 codes. She will send you a message. Later on in the show, we have some nice swag from our friends at Ernie Ball. So we'll be giving away some strings and some accessories that sort of any guitarist or bassist can use. We have a guitar pack and a bass pack. Mr. Pody, you actually get to pick the next person who will be up on our... That would be Greg. Gregory Barr. Hello, Greg.
Hello.
Oh, and Greg's ready. Greg came ready for a fight. Quite literally came ready for a fight. So...
You guys ready for some cardio boxing?
Misty is taking care of the... Come on in. Here, do you want to step around or step behind? I don't know how the hell you're going to play guitar with boxing gloves on.
I'm just going to do it.
But I'm really glad that you are. Yeah. You can strum, I suppose. That's good.
I dance.
You came to fight. I'm doing fine. You don't even know what game you're going to play yet.
Nope.
Do you want to...
I'm ready. Am I picking the...
You can pick your opponent. Would you rather pick the opponent first? Sure. Go ahead. Well, don't look. You're not allowed to look. I mean, that's the rule of picking. You don't look. Why do you think I got these great mugs?
Jared!
Jared will be facing... Jared will be facing Greg in Ninja Slide N.
Oh.
All right, so Ninja Slide N.
Let's see what that is.
Similar to where String Skip Saloon teaches you to sort of automatically teach your hands which string is where and how far to reach, this teaches you how far to slide between the frets. So you can, if you see a slide coming up that says go from the 3rd fret to the 6th fret, this is a game that will help you build that skill. So we'll let you tune up just in case the other guys did anything terrible. Oh, they may have done something terrible. Yes, well done. All right, how do you feel about Ninja Slide N? Is this something you're good at?
We'll see. I've been studying a lot of film. I've been preparing for the fight.
Oh, all right, good for you.
Figuring out the weaknesses and, you know.
Sure.
I'm gonna give what do you my think? Best shot.
Well, I would ask you what Jared's weaknesses are, but we only have an hour today, so.
It slides.
See, this is one of those wrestling things where at the end the referee gets hit with a chair. So all right, if you're ready,
I'm ready.
I think the game will pretty much explain itself. You're starting on the 3rd fret and chasing Greg. Chasing Greg will be a sort of electrical storm trying to knock him off of these towers. There are little ghosts that circle some of these towers, and he slices them. He times his slide while they're passing by, and he'll slide them. You're doing slide faster. It's telling you slide faster. But of course, if you fall off the towers, it would break your streak. Well, you notice that the path between the towers is red, which is telling him he's doing this on the low E string. Now, as if on cue, go to the blue string, which is the 3rd string. Doing quite well. Doing very well. Oh, and one of the ghosts, you sliced the ghost that said switch the strings, so now you're back on the red low G string. Low E. There you go. Congratulations to our DLC winners, by the way. I see this. Have won. Oh, hurry, hurry, hurry! Oh, you've been electrocuted at 605,000 points. Try sliding with other fingers to toughen them up. 605 is pretty good. Actually, 605,000 is better than I do when I play. So, well done. I think you've set it. I think you've set an impressive bar. We'll get Mr. McAdams in here. I didn't even mean it. Do you want to say? Do you want to put the gloves on so you can actively punch Jared while he comes on? Oh, come on around, Jared. So, Jared McAdams, you know him from various things. He's going to jump in. If you're coming, look at this. He's just calling a shot, walking in front, walking over all the cables. If you're just tuning in, we're doing our first, possibly last, Guitarcade Showdown. In part because Audio Slave is our DLC this week, and we actually do not have permission to stream that. No harm, no foul. It's just part of the licensing deal. So we thought we'd do something fun and something different, show you part of the game that we don't normally do on the stream. Jared McAdams.
Dan Amherst.
How are you?
I'm swell.
You saw what Greg Barr did.
I saw part of it.
I know you are a part-time ninja outside of the game.
That's not public knowledge, but I guess it is now, so
all right,
thanks.
I didn't mean to ruin your Halloween costume either, but what do you think? What do you think? Greg Barr was talking some smack. He said that it would take an hour.
He
if
got
we were
up
gonna...
into the 600,000.
He did. He got 605,000.
All right.
He just barely made it over.
If I can get almost half of that, I'll feel pretty good.
That won't win, though. You realize that. That's not a win.
It'll be a moral victory.
All right.
For me.
Great. He's going for a moral victory.
Yeah.
Those of you who are betting at home, don't bet, but place your bets now. And
yeah, anger.
Jared's got Eye of the Tiger. Fingers of, I don't know what.
Available now.
Yeah. Yes, he's got Eye of the Tiger as DLC from Survivor. All right.
What?
He doesn't. Oh, he's going to do this with an extra level of difficulty. He doesn't
need
headphones.
Okay, no, wait. Pause.
Suddenly he thought perhaps that's... this actually is a game that you could play without. So do it. Hurry. You're live, man. Back on three. I wish I were reading the chat just to see what everyone is saying.
What?
4-6. 4-6. Switching strings.
Oh,
to the G
orange.
String. Orange. What? There you go.
Cold Tony.
Again, if you're just starting to learn how to play, or if you've been playing for a while, these are kind of skills that you can always use a little refresher on. You can always build up. Oops, you split up to 10. Ready? And here comes the electric wall. You've got a lot of ground to cover. Only 180,000 points to try to beat Greg Barr. You're going to need to slice a lot more ghosts as you go. 4-8, 4-8, you can do it. No, he can't, said the peanut gallery in the room. Oh, 280,000.
Almost half.
Almost half. It's a moral victory. It's a moral victory.
That was fun.
Thank you very much.
That was a lot of
fun. That was well done. Is this... I mean, you can't...
I leveled up and you didn't.
Yeah, well, yes, but that's, as you've noticed, you can only get 3 stars on a level. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right, well, fine. You leveled up. I'm not going to take that away from you because there's almost nothing else to give you.
I need it.
Hey, before you go, would you like to pick the next victim?
I'm good at this part.
Yeah, you're very good. We know that Matt and Nick are in the room and in the Ubisoft mug as well. So, hey, look, and we've got an equipable inlay for our fretboard, too. Just one would be great. Taylor Benson. Yeah, show the camera, although I think it's too far away that they can't tell. Doesn't matter. It's Taylor Benson. Taylor Benson is coming up. While Taylor gets in place, and you may remember Taylor from all of those helpful instructional videos that tell you how to set up your audio and stuff like that. Hi, Taylor. Welcome back.
Hello.
We have another thing to give away. I guess we should give that away now. Let's the tension. We'll do that, and we'll find out your opponent after this that they always do on all the game shows. We're gonna give away the Ernie Ball guitar pack now. So Misty, if you're standing by, and I'm sure you are, this is what we've got to give you. We've got 2 packs of Ernie Ball Slinky strings, including a pack of their new Cobalt strings, which are louder and more powerful. We've got a packet of Wonder Wipes, which will keep the guitar in good shape. You can clean it. You can condition the fretboard. A whole bunch of stuff that people don't do nearly enough. A nice black strap, which will go with whatever kind of guitar you have, plus some picks and a peg winder for when you change those strings. So we'll give away one of these. You do not have to be in America to win this. I am shipping internationally until they tell me otherwise. But you will need to send your name, your address, and your phone number, because we often ship UPS and FedEx, and our mailroom requires a phone number in case something goes wrong. We don't use it for anything else, and we don't save your information, so don't freak out. But Misty will need all that information. But first, you have to win the giveaway, and she'll take care of that now. So while you guys are going raffle, 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 why don't you pick your opponent in whatever game this might possibly be? It's Nick Bernardi. Nick Bernardi, you may remember if you followed the stream for a while, you may remember that Nick some weeks ago came on and showed us all about session mode, which was kind of awesome. So Nick will be back. You guys will be playing Hurtlin' Hurdles.
Yes.
Hurtlin' Hurdles will teach you how to tremolo pick, and that's something that you don't get enough practice doing. What you doing, man? It's just three down. There we go. Oh, yes, and we brought out the stadium for you guys. Isn't that great? That's how big this event is. Why don't you go ahead and tune? Hurtlin' Hurdles. Nick Bernardi, you're up next. You're fighting Taylor in Hurtlin' Hurdles. So tremolo pick the matching string as fast as you can, and then mute the strings to jump over obstacles, and there's a giant crusher that's going to try to kill you from behind. So here you go. All I hear, I don't know if we have game audio, Brian. Oh, you're very good at this. That's all right. That's all right. Okay, the battery's coming in. You can get a nice leap forward if you can grab the battery in this. There he goes, 79,000 points, a nice 80,000 points. He's way ahead of the Crusher. Oh, the Crusher is making time. But you are getting perfects on this. That's kind of wonderful.
No!
Oh, very nice. Keep going. Switch to the yellow string.
Ooh.
See, if you had practiced strings... If you've practiced String Skip Saloon, then this game is a little bit easier. Oh, missed the battery.
There it is.
Run for your life. 208,000. You're doing very, very well, though. I'm really impressed with how well you're doing. Back to the G string.
I'm always back to the G string.
Hey, it's a show. 306,000 and counting. There we go. A nice leap forward with the battery. Gained about 30,000 on that battery. That was great. 35,000, a huge leap up to the yellow string. Finally crushed at 528,000 points. I am super impressed with that, and I think that's going to be very difficult to hit. I think you've set an extreme. I'm saying, why don't you go behind the magic curtain and get in place, because you're next using this same guitar, and you'll just replace Taylor on the couch. Taylor, do you have any taunts that you want to throw out to Nick? Because, you know, you guys go way back.
Oh, yeah, no, I would never say anything like that to Nick. I mean, you know, other than he's terrible at this. And
all right, well, here we go. We're going to bring in Nick Bernardi. Congratulations to whoever won the thing with the What's It. I will mail out your Ernie Ball prizes as soon as Misty sends me your information. Let's bring in Nick. Hi, Nick. Welcome back to the show, Nick.
Hello.
Hi.
How you doing?
It's going all right. Why is the game screen so small? Because we've just got that switched in for right now. We can switch it back.
Of all of the mini games that I could have hoped to play today,
this was the wrong one?
This is definitely the worst one.
Oh, all right. Excellent. Yeah. So, Taylor, congratulations. The luck of the draw.
I'm not going to congratulate him on a win so far. I'm going to try my best, but this is definitely the worst one. Also, I think it's unfair to have a tester in the ranks of playing.
Hey, I opened it up to anybody that wanted to do it, and I took all comers.
I'm just putting it out there.
That's all right. No, pre-complain. It's fine.
I'm gonna pre-complain.
It's totally your right. You can do that. How you been?
I've been good.
Yeah?
Yeah, have you been?
You made this.
So... I didn't make this one. Actually, Matt Montgomery made all of the music for all of these video games for Rocksmith 2014. This one especially is pretty great for that.
And the fact that it's original music is the reason we can stream it this week.
Yes.
Because we have permission. Thank you for the permission, Matt. Much appreciated.
Wait, did you ask Matt, actually?
I'll ask Matt. You know what? I think Matt's going to win.
Never mind. Let's just move on. Let's not.
I think Matt's going to win when he comes up. All right. Well, you saw Taylor basically give a lesson on how this is done.
I was right. I was right there.
So,
just watching from right over there.
So it's all up to you. If you can beat 528,000, you leave with glory and little else. Obviously the undying love and support of the chat room, but Nick made Space Ostrich, so there, you know, you have fans out there. Here we go. Tremolo picking away. This is called Hurtlin' Hurdles.
Not off to a good start.
And this is available as one of the 10 games in the Guitarcade mode of Rocksmith 2014. You have this. You may not even realize that you have it.
You may not realize you have it.
Yeah, well, a lot of people we know, a lot of people are motivated to play songs by bands that they love, and, you know, that inspires them to pick up the guitar, and that's totally cool. But there's something to be said for building your skills outside of those songs, and that's why a guitar game exists. You've recovered quite well. You could use a battery, but other than that, I'd say that you're on your way to 500,000. Drop back a little bit. Mute.
Oh, that was so close.
That was so incredibly close. Nick is like, shut up.
I don't care.
Everybody.
I'm just going to run through all the hurdles. I don't need to jump them.
Jump. Yeah, all right. Okay. We're into the 113,000 mark now. Right. Still several hundred thousand to go, but you can do it. Tail proof that it's possible.
Go.
That doesn't actually help, but I don't blame you for doing it. Yes, well done. Didn't even jump for it. Waited for the battery to come to him. That's Bernardi style.
No!
Oh, just during the stream skip. Oh, you had it. Throws the pick in disgust. I'm still impressed. It's a difficult game.
That actually was the best run of that game I've ever done. And I'm proud to do the best run on air.
It's enshrined for all time for the internet. Would you like to pick the next victim? Because I would like
you
to pick the next victim.
First, I'd like to say, Taylor, you're the victor. You're the better of this. So,
yeah. Your words.
My. Who's next?
Who's next on the Guitarcade Showdown, which is a lot lower energy than I expected it to be, I gotta say. Everybody's like, we're hungry.
David.
David Stevens. Hello, David. Put down the laptop, and thank you very much, Nick.
Yeah, thanks,
Dan. We're actually gonna, why don't you come over and take my space, because we're gonna take a brief break before you come on. And when we come back, we're actually gonna do a backtrack. We are allowed to do the backtrack, and if you haven't read Sam Schwartz's excellent write-up of Hitch a Ride by Boston in our forums, you can do that now, or you can watch this very informative video about Guitarcade if it's new to you. And then we'll come back, and David will actually be playing bass with Sam on guitar for Hitch a Ride by Boston. And then we will have you choose who it is that you'll be fighting in the fourth of our five showdowns. We also have some Ernie Ball swag to come for you basses, so stick around. But for now, watch this, and we'll be right back.
In Rocksmith 2014, we've got 11 new Guitarcade games. Guitarcade is the area of Rocksmith where you can learn new skills such as, you know, bends, slides, tremolos, chords, and all that, and brush up on your techniques in a less formal, less structured environment. Dux Redux is the Dux game that we always wanted to make. It's probably the first one you played in Rocksmith 1, and it's really simple. You're moving up and down the fretboard. Last time we were limited to just the top string, and now as you progress, you'll get to do it on every string on the guitar. Scale Racer is an 80s style arcade racer where you're learning guitar scales. You're on the run from the cops, and as you play the scales up and down the guitar neck, you go faster and faster to get away from the cops. You can either play the next note early for more bonus points, or wait until just the last second to crash the cop car that's chasing you into the oncoming traffic. It's light years beyond anything we did in Rocksmith 1. Gone Whalin' is another one of the all-new minigames we've added to Guitarcade for Rocksmith 2014. Gone Whalin's all about dynamics, and the louder you play, the higher the guy goes. The softer you play, the lower he goes. A lot of beginners just play as loud as they can. And the true masters, the guys who really know what they're doing with the guitar, they know it's all about your fingertips. It's all about your touch and how soft you can play. Gone Whalen helps you learn that. The most popular guitar arcade game in Rocksmith 1 was Dawn of the Chordette, where you learned chord shapes and shot up approaching hordes of little zombies. So Return to Castle Chordette has more zombies, more chords, more everything. There's boss battles, there's cutscenes, there's a great tongue-in-cheek story. It's in every way a nod to 90s, you know, rail shooters. One of the things that people loved about Guitar Arcade before was that we had leaderboards for every game. You could check your high score against the world. We've kept that, but we've made it better. Instead of just passively checking your position on the leaderboard against the rest of the world, Rocksmith actually looks at where you are on the leaderboard and sends challenges your way. The leaderboard challenges provide never-ending motivation to keep getting better at the games themselves, but then also at guitar. When we shipped Rocksmith 1, everyone said that it was a classic rhythm game, but with a real guitar. That wasn't necessarily the case. It's a great learning tool. In Rocksmith 2014, we've made the learning better, but we've also added Score Attack, which is essentially a classic rhythm game, but with a real guitar. It's all the stuff that you expect: locked difficulty, head-to-head battles, duets. Everything is just so much better. The learning is better. It's more fun. It really is just another thing that makes Rocksmith 2014 the best way to learn guitar.
And as you've noticed, October 2013 is come and gone. But you will be able to get all of those Guitarcade games when Rocksmith 2014 comes out in early November for PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. If you haven't heard that news, yes, we have officially confirmed that the games are on their way, and we're just weeks away. So if you know a friend that maybe didn't pick up Rocksmith last year because they were investing in new hardware, well, now they have no excuse. They can buy our game for their newest hardware. Hi, Sam and Dave.
Hello.
That's you guys should go on the road. That wouldn't be copyright infringement at all. So you guys are going to do Hitch a Ride. This is our backtrack. If you haven't seen the forums, go to rocksmith.ubi.com and look in the DLC sub-discussion. And Sam has written up a nice little piece about Hitch a Ride and things that you can learn about it from a music theory level, right? You were talking about, like, the scales and...
There's a couple of things in this song that are really cool that I love about it. the thing that I think about for this song in particular, the bass and the rhythm charts, like, for people who think bass and rhythm are sort of throwaway things in this game, it's such a great chart for that, because there's so much creativity going on in both of those charts. There's a lot to explore, you know.
Okay.
And with regards to the scalar stuff that he's doing in the solo, like he, and it's this sixth, which I was talking about in the write-up, where he really like emphasizes that, which is a big classic rock thing. You'll hear almost every 70s rock, like, guitar player that's doing lead stuff emphasize that six, and it really gives it that, like, funkiness, that soul. And I was sort of talking about this scale that exists that's... It's just a pentatonic scale, and you add the sixth into it, so... Mm. You know, a lot of players... It just adds that flavor in.
All right. Show us in context.
Yeah,
why
man.
Don't you?
Let's do it.
We're going to do Hitch a Ride. If you're just tuning in, we're doing a Guitarcade showdown this week. So we'll be back to the Bloodsport in a moment. But in the meantime, we're also doing Hitch a Ride by Boston as our backtrack. This is available as DLC for all platforms. And if you miss this, there's plenty to learn. Also take some of your questions while we're playing the song. I'll dig in through the chat here, see if there's anything I can answer. I will point out that we do have a handy fact for the
lot of common things that come up on our chats here, specifically here. Probably answer most of your questions about things like how to request songs or what have you. Somebody had asked why Paul Cross was not on the stream this week. Paul has been invited and Paul is interested in being on the stream, but as you can imagine, as the creative director of the whole studio, Paul is a busy guy. So when Paul's schedule allows him to come on, we will welcome him with open arms. I do not know whether we'll convince him to play guitar or not, but at the very least, we'll be doing some Q&A. Barely a Bear 45 asks, did you guys already do the Steam Code giveaway? Yes, we did, but we are still giving away an Ernie Ball baseball. Strings, accessories, and a whole bunch of stuff. I'm happy to send it to you wherever it is, if you are the person who wins it. Will we ever see Tweaks more than five songs? That's a good question. Don't really know. You know, generally we do three, four, and five songs. It keeps the prices in a reasonable realm. It's not unheard of. You know, we would consider if we had a really good reason to do it. But it would really depend on the material. His second question is, what does Nick use for his hair product? And Nick has gone away, so I'm going to guess Roundup Orphans. I think it's the only way that something like that could look that good. What do you think it is? Whale blubber? Could be whale blubber. Whatever it is, it's probably highly illegal and you can't get hair like that. Has there ever been any thought to display actual note letters as an option? Yes, there has. Next question. A lot of the decisions that you see along those lines about what information to offer to the player, yeah, a lot of things were prototyped, a lot of things were tried, and the things that we went with were the things that worked the best, the things that were the clearest. There's always other ways to do it. But ultimately, you're seeing, you know, our recommendations on how to best learn to play guitar. Not necessarily learn music theory or learn how to read music, but if you're looking to learn how to play the guitar through familiar songs, that's what Box Rings is designed to do. Not that we haven't considered those ideas or wouldn't reconsider those ideas in any sort of future product, but that's why things are the way they are, because they made the most sense to us at the time we were making them. Dan, hey Straygar, you said there was some big stuff coming in this fall and winter for DLC. Did you mean Farner and Audioslave, or is there still a big hit coming? There are so many hits, you will not, your mind cannot comfortably conceive. We're in the middle of a segment here of DLC releases that we're all extremely proud about at the studio. As you know, we have to ask all the artists for permission and stuff like that. No, we are, this is the beginning of the hits. Let me put it that way. Audioslave and, really from like Boxsmith on is kind of what I saw as like, wow, there's a lot of really recognizable artists. Beautiful work, guys. I'm talking away about songs that aren't Boston, but don't think I don't notice your brilliance. That's very, very good.
Exemplary performance.
Thank you.
Well done. Anything you want to add on to that? Because I'll go back to answer my other thing. Actually, the short answer is there's plenty to come. Stick around. Watch every week. You won't believe some of the stuff that's in the hopper.
Sure.
So you did your sixth. You hit that sixth. What else? You had to do the bass, David. Anything to add?
It's kind of all over the place. I really like that every section of the song is a little bit different. You don't just fall into the same rhythm over and over and over again.
Cool. Are you ready?
I'm also a big fan of the organ in that song. It's a great organ player.
Yes. I was like, organ? What?
I think the guy who plays organ plays lead, rhythm, and bass on that song as well. I think he did all the parts. I think Tom.
Oh, is it Tom Schultz? Is it all Tom Schultz? Because he's like studio wizard.
I mean, if you watch him live, he puts his guitar on his back and does this, and then he brings it up and he does that.
He's a pretty amazing dude.
Yeah, he is.
All right. Well, thank you, guys. And David, you need to swap over, grab the other guitar, and pick your next victim, so that somebody knows who's coming in next. Here, I will take this from you, and I will throw it away. No, we love that Explorer bass. A lot of people have asked about the instruments that we have. These are a mix of personal owned instruments and studio owned instruments, and the beautiful Explorer bass happens to be one of the instruments that the studio owns, as is my Les Paul. I'm the steward of this. This is kind of like my daily guitar, but it really belongs to the studio. Although I am thinking of making an offer. I'm starting to fall in, because I've customized it all. I don't want to get rid of it. I kind of want to own it. So you're all warmed up.
Let's
so this
do
is
it.
Like already not fair.
Blood in the water.
Who will you be fighting in our Guitarcade showdown?
McCune.
Come on, brother. So Brian McCune will be battling David Stevens in this Guitarcade showdown. And I am telling you that is Gone Whalen.
Guitarcade.
This is a tricky... Oh, boo hiss. This is a... We're haunted, kids. So what we're doing this week is we're doing a Guitarcade showdown, a nice little fisticuffs dust-up among the folks here, because Audio Slave is our DLC this week. It's available on all platforms now, and that's wonderful. But we don't have permission to stream it. It's just a necessary thing. So we're going to calibrate the guitar. There we go. Now we're going to calibrate the guitar. If you're not calibrating the guitar on a regular basis, folks, you should be, because you don't want to miss notes for silly reasons like, hey, my guitar is not calibrated. If you switch instruments a lot, that's extremely important.
It's very important for this game.
Yeah, and Gone Whalen in particular. So this is all about learning how to play not everything at 100%, just hit the string as hard as you can. There's something to be said for picking lightly. A lot of songs require dynamics, and that's what this is supposed to do. Except here, dynamics will be played. The part of dynamics will be played by Digital Bananas. So, are you ready?
I'm ready.
You're feeling good about this?
No.
You
are.
Well, you were one of the other odds-on favorites for because you, being our QA ninja, you're the guy who, you play these a little bit more frequently. I suppose Taylor has played them the most, but.
Sure.
People were concerned about facing you, and of course McCune now has to stare death right in the face.
I promise not to cheat.
Okay. Oh, is there a cheat?
There's a cheat.
Do you want to
not
share?
Not really a cheat. I feel
an advanced technique.
You're really trying to learn to control dynamics, and if you want to adjust your volume knob while you play, it makes a big
difference. Oh no! Yeah, do not cheat. This is this is about picking. This is not about learning how to play Cathedral by Van Halen. This is about just picking. So go ahead and make some noise, and good luck. Brian McCune will be up next. We still have an Ernie Ball giveaway to do, so stick around for that. So the whole goal is to vary how heavy or light you pick to pick up all these bananas. Brian McCune is already going, I don't know if I can beat this. Look at you have really good technique. That's beautiful. Obviously, if you hit any obstacles, you'll be in trouble. This stuff is very difficult to do, but again, it's an incredible skill to learn, and it will help you in everything that you do on guitar. If you happen to drop on top of any one of these little mesas, you will not die. You will just keep running. Thank you for demonstrating that on cue. But the birds will knock you off. Brian, you can only hope you get a run that easy with three. Yeah, this is way longer than I can usually do it, too, so congratulations. I'm curious to see... one dirty joke and I completely lost my pattern. 244,920, we'll call it 245. And we'll round up Brian by probably about 100,000 just to make it even, okay?
McCune!
You're up, my friend. Come on over and we'll see how you do on Gone Whalen. Do you have any advice for folks at home on how to do that? I mean...
If you really want to drop fast, mute.
Sure.
Hey. That's the best advice I can give.
All right. Other than that, it's just teaching your hands how to make those motions.
Don't hit the birds.
Don't hit the birds. All right. We won't hit the birds. Brian McCune. Yes, you don't want angry birds because that would not be a success at all. Hi, Brian. How are you?
I'm great.
You're ready to... you're not great. You're not looking forward to this at all, are you?
I am. Let's do this.
All right. McCune sort of rushing to the executioner's platform to get it over with.
Yeah.
245. Boy, you don't even get bananas like at the beginning. At
yeah,
level.
These are easy.
Yeah, I like your dynamics are excellent. Woo! A lot of people say that when I don't play, it sounds the best. So I understand. This is also just really good practice for Mizzer Lou. No, you're all right. As long as the land is linked, you'll be okay, and you don't have to worry about it. No, you're doing quite well. David, what was your score? 245? 245 and 244 and change. Whale's starting to speed up, but you're hitting good combos. Play it safe, because you gotta get distance. It's alright. Drop it down, you're fine. Beautiful move. Ryan's a shark. 200. 245. Oh, you won! Oh, the comeback kid. Well done, Brian. Ah, super impressive.
All right.
So, wow. Yeah, what was your performance enhancing?
I mixed
was it Coke
Diet
Zero?
Coke and Dr. Pepper this
Diet time. Coke and Dr. Pepper. There you go. The McCune cocktail will get you through. Oh, right. Super good job. Great come from behind. You. Wow, we actually see live TV. Live sports is the only live drama left on television, and we're stealing it today. Thank you very much.
I thank you for being surprised that I won.
I was well, do you remember a couple of weeks ago when I said I'm not one of the best people on guitar in the office, and you said, I wouldn't say that. Other people would say that, but I wouldn't say that. I have not forgotten that, Brian. Thank you very much. It's a foregone conclusion, but would you like to choose?
Yes.
Since we since we know, go ahead, and then I'll let the next person, whoever this is.
Rian.
Is it upside down?
I'm kidding.
Oh, Ryan. Oh, it'd be Ryan DeBolt, of course. That's Ryan. Hey, Ryan, come on over. Come around the back way. And thank you, Mr. McCune. You can just leave that there because he's going to use that guitar. It would not be fair. Oh, you're not bringing in one of these corked bats, sir. You're playing the blue Les Paul to keep it even. Although we all love your 60s tribute SG. Come around. Don't get it. This is the hosting chair today. Hi, Brian DeBolt. How are you, my friend?
I'm good. I'm great.
Are you? Since there is no drama to the fact that there's one other person and they're in the room and they know who they are and they were one of the first people picked and they weren't here when they were picked, so we'll just say it's Matt Montgomery. Yes, Matt will be facing you, but...
I have to face Matt? Oh, hey, I love this one.
We're going into Ducks. Our last game of the day is Ducks. We will be giving away the Ernie Ball base pack. Don't go anywhere. Actually, you know what? Misty, why don't we do that now while we get things going for Ducks Redux for our last game. We have this lovely pack to give away from Ernie Ball. We've got some picks. We've got a string winder. We've got some Wonder Wipes. We've got a nice black strap that will work with just about anything. And I should also point out that we have two sets of bass strings. If you're a bassist, you know you generally don't have to change your strings very often. So a set of regular Slinkies and a set of Slinky Cobalts should keep you set for a long time. So our moderator, Misty, will take care of you right now with the instructions on what to do to enter this giveaway. All this wonderful stuff that you see can be yours. And I do recommend those Wonder Wipes. I don't think people do enough maintenance on their guitar. And so if you're not cleaning it on a regular basis, if you're not trying to recondition the fretboard naturally wood has oil in it, and your hands tend to put the wrong kind of oil. They strips the oil out of the wood and then puts different side of gunky oil in. So you want to restore that, and Wonder Wipes will help you do that. So Ducks Redux is a sequel to a game from the original Rocksmith that you may remember. It was just called Ducks, I think. This is going to be really good at helping you learn how to navigate the fretboard automatically. Wow, are you ready to witness your first Duxplosion?
Oh, yes.
How are you at Dux for Dux?
I usually play it on bass.
Usually play it on bass, so we're adding two strings. But you know what? The concept is the same. Yeah. It's be all right. I believe in you. Right. I believe in Matt a little bit more, but I do believe in you somewhat.
I believe in Matt.
So here we go. Sixth fret. All you have to do is, when the ducks appear, play that fret on that string. There's a rainbow duck in the back that Ryan has missed. The electric wall on the back is going to creep towards you slowly. And the more ducks you get, some of them have shields. There we go. If you hit the rainbow duck in the back, you'll switch strings, and now you've got to move over to the D string, the blue string. And you'll see a couple of pixels showing you where the next duck will appear if you look closely on the strings at the bottom. Sooner or later, you do have to switch strings to reset the electrical wall. So you can't just sit there and farm ducks on one string the whole time. You're doing quite well, 487,000 points. The wall is a good far distance away. I'm looking forward to this. Matt is studying notes, taking notes on your technique right now to figure out how to defeat you. And yes, this is sort of String Skip Saloon in the other direction on the fretboard. Well done. 2.3 million. Thank you for also proving that if you play bass, guitar isn't really that much harder, as you're demonstrating right now.
It's like riding a bike.
To the A-string now. We're speeding up. You can see the electric fence is moving in faster. The 18th fret.
Come on.
Don't let the duck escape.
It's not good.
It is difficult to play at the higher frets.
Oh, I think I was on the right string.
Oh, and if you were at the, it's definitely difficult to do at the highest if you're not on the right string. Well, that's very good. That's certainly, I vastly underestimated you. I figured I had you at like 2,000 or 3,000, and so you got 5.7 million. So congratulations on that. Well done.
Thank you. I'll remember that.
Do you want to you give any shout-outs? Anybody you want to thank?
I want to thank all the little ducks.
Yeah, they gave their lives.
For
the pixelated,
giving their lives.
The pixelated ducks.
Better.
Well, Matt table. Montgomery has quite a thing to hit, so why don't you get the hell off of my couch, and we'll let Matt get in. We'll let Matt get in for our last one of the day. Hopefully, you guys. Let's see. Do I see a whole bunch of raffles? Did Misty give away the stuff? Yes, Misty gave away the Ernie Ball base pack. So, again, make sure that you send your phone number along with your name and address to Misty the way that she asks you to send it to her, and then she will forward that to me, and I will hit the mailroom and give them everything they need. And thank you very much for tuning in. We like to give you stuff. We know you're not here for us. You know, you would think that just tuning in to see Matt Montgomery in person would be enough, but no, you need free things. It's not. They need free things. They're greedy bastards in our chat. hi, Matt. Welcome.
Hi.
Sorry you're all tangled up. All right, I want you to be comfortable because 5.7 is nothing to sneeze at.
I'll sneeze at.
Please don't sneeze. I am in close proximity to you. I'm sorry, you don't even get to do anything with our cool Ubisoft mugs. Congratulations, you win a Ubisoft mug for just for showing up. No, the dude that I stole those off his desk, he's going to be like, what? So, are you ready to do this? Are you familiar with the Dux for Dux? Are you good at Dux for Dux? Would you consider yourself amateur, intermediate, or pro?
Better than Ryan.
Better than Ryan is really all that it matters. It's like you don't have to run fast. You just have to run faster than the last guy in the horde when the zombie apocalypse comes. So, yeah. All right, so 5.7 million is your target. Let's see if you can do it. It's like you already know your way around a fretboard. No, Ryan's already nervous. He's in the back going, oh, no, this is going to be terrible. Up to the B string. I love the Ottawa sound effects, by the way. Thank you, Brandon Wesley. It was who? Oh, Longtail? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm crediting the wrong people. Thank you, Longtail Studios. You may have noticed those guys. We have their logo on our loading screen along with Red Storm. It's a group effort. But if you're wondering how to get that sound on your guitar, you can go into the Game Designer and play around with it. off to a good start. 562,000 and the multipliers are cranking. Every time you hit one of the rainbow ducks, it also adds a multiplier.
Ah,
you let the duck escape. It specifically said don't let the duck escape.
Oh, I got that.
Oh, here we go, here we go.
Aw.
Yes!
Ryan.
Woo!
Ryan is thrilled in the background. I'm disappointed.
I'm disappointed.
I think you should be disappointed. Wait, now I've heard who's really good? Taylor's really good at Gone Whaling? He's all right. After seeing that, because you were called out in one of the breaks, like, we should really get Taylor playing Gone Whaling.
Yeah.
We have a little bit of time. Do you want to cap this? Brian did so well. I'm not doing this to take anything away from Brian. Brian did an amazing come from behind victory. Thank you, Matt. I appreciate you giving it a shot. No, don't walk off in shame. As the Motley Crue song says, don't go away, Matt, just go away. Hi, Taylor. You're back for your victory lap.
Yeah.
Well, Gone Whaling, I think, is one of the hardest games. I think it's really quite difficult, so I'd love to see somebody else do this.
Sure. I will do my best.
You will have to calibrate, because that's crucial for this.
Absolutely.
I do want to point out that one of the questions we get a lot is, how do I get Rocksmith picks? And you may notice that we sometimes use Rocksmith picks here. I will include them. If you win one of our packages, one of our physical packages, something that I'm mailing out, the Ernie Ball packages will come with Ernie Ball picks as well as a handful of Rocksmith picks. We do not have them for sale at this time. If you see me in person, I'll be happy to give you some. I generally have some on my person at all times, part of my contract. Yeah, so you just picked up a Rocksmith pick, and that's what made me think about it. So...
they're fantastic.
This is just exhibition. This is just a victory lap. Give it a shot. I'd like to see you do this. And you're on level 2 because this did level up. So
yeah.
You're automatically going to get a higher score. Your score does not count.
All right.
But we're going for distance. We're going for speed.
Hey, why don't you guys have cake deal?
It's funny you mention cake DLC, because even though I'm doing Motley Crue lyric callouts, we actually have cake in the game. Yes, we have requested Motley Crue. No, we do not yet have permission for Motley Crue. Let's hope that all happens someday. But if you're watching, thanks for tuning in this week. We did something a little bit different. Audio Slave is this week's DLC, and on our way out, we will give you another look at it. But we still have permission. Do-over?
No.
Do-over? No?
Well, all right.
Do-over! Everybody in the crowd is shouting for do-over.
For reference,
this...
I didn't get a do-over,
says people in the back. Yeah, well.
This game is bananas.
That's why we didn't do Audio Slave DLC this week. But we still, we enjoy streaming and we enjoy having this time with you. So thanks for tuning in wherever you are. Remember, you can always find replays of this stuff on our Twitch channel here where you're watching, or on our YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/UbisoftStudioSF, all one word. That makes it easy to say pass around your friends or embed on your Facebook posts or something if you see us do something fun or funny. I will probably put up Brian McCune's... ooh, that's dangerous. I will probably put up Brian McCune's heroic win as a highlight this week, so I think that's totally warranted.
It was excellent.
It was a beautiful cruise boat. Nick Bernardi wants you to fail. Oh, look at how it speeds up now. Of course, we will be doing DLC every week from now until we're not. There is no expiration date on DLC, so this week it's Audio Slave. Last week it was Foreigner. What's it going to be next week? Tune in tomorrow in the official Rocksmith forums. Beautiful, Taylor. You are really good at this. Next week, tomorrow in the Rocksmith forums, I will post a little clue, a little game for everybody, so that you can figure out what we're going to bring out next week. It is another artist that I think you will recognize. Taylor, you're really incredibly good at this game.
Redemption!
Holy cow, this is pro level. I am super impressed. Way to go!
Oh!
That was heroic. 1.8 million. Way to go, man. Super great.
Thank you.
That's awesome. We're going to leave on a high note.
It's super fun.
I think that's great.
The guitar games are always a blast.
Yeah, so if you're not playing them, obviously there's a lot of fun to be had. This does track on leaderboards with your friends, so if you'd like to throw down the gauntlet with people you know, there you go. Where you just scored on behalf of Rocksmith 987
on next,
Steam.
Rocka barely.
Taylor's coming for you. So, well, hey, on behalf of everybody here, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching the Guitarcade Showdown. Congratulations to our winners. There's really no losers here, just five people that weren't good enough to win. And we'll be back next week with another stream. Audio Slave DLC is out this week for PS3, Xbox 360, and Steam on PC. If you didn't win Steam codes this week on the stream, tune in tomorrow to our Twitter, because at twitter.com/UbisoftStudioSF. I will be giving away some codes there. Also, we'll drop a few to our friends on Reddit and a few in our official forums at rocksmith.ubi.com. So there's still more free things for you, and we'll be back next week with another stream. Goodbye, everybody, and farewell from champion, because nobody else could do that, Taylor Benson. Thanks for joining us again this week,
Thank
Taylor.
Thank you for having
awesome.
Me.
Awesome. Bye, everybody.